Hi all. Today I'm here with Constantine, and we're gonna look into actually working on a tenant creation. So, Constantine, why don't you introduce yourself?
Hi, my name's Konstantin Kaminski. I've been working in the Office 365 and then Microsoft 365 and Azure space for the last 6 years. And over that time, I've made a fair few tenants. And I was speaking with Andre, and he asked me how I go about making tenants. And I showed him a trick, and here we are making a video of it.
That sounds good. So, okay, without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so there are two main ways of creating a tenant. The first way is that if you already have a tenant, we're going to go through that first, because you can create an additional tenant on that tenant, or you create a tenant completely from scratch. We will cover both of them, but for the first bit, I just want to cover this bit. So, considering we, of course, go to portal.azure.com, our most favorite site, right?
A portal, yes.
Yes, and then what we do is we click on Azure Active Directory. Then we can click on Manage Tenants. And as you can see, I have a couple of tenants over here. Now, if I wanted to, if I already have this for learning or for anything else, I can create a new tenant. I can specify, in this case, it's going to be Azure Active Directory. You need to create it because currently in this tenant, I haven't created a subscription, so I can't do BTC, but we're just going to do Azure Active Directory. We're gonna pick Caf Terraform 3, I think 4. I've created a few of them now, so I don't know where we are. So let's try Caf Terraform 4. I'm gonna pick my country, which is the United Kingdom, and then we will click Next, Review and Create, and Create. And then after some time, well, I first will need to confirm the letters actually. This will create the tenant for us, right? So now we just give it a couple of minutes. It takes a couple of minutes to create this. So we're just gonna wait. Right, now that's actually happened, we now see that a new tenant has been created, which is the Caf Terraform 4. Okay, so in this case, if we look at this tenant, it's actually there. It's got the old ID and everything. And if you just, you may have to just refresh your page, but if you create it with your account, you can actually switch directory and you can switch to that tenant. So now, instead of actually creating multiple tenants per different email addresses, you can have it all in one learning profile. And again, for this course, I recommend that you have a completely brand new tenant. And that's why, that's best to do this. Now that we've actually created the tenant using an existing tenant, let us show you how you can create a tenant if you've actually starting completely from scratch. So Constantine, why don't you let me know exactly how to drive this?
Okay, so the important thing is that you'd want to do this in an incognito window just so you can avoid interactions with potential existing other Microsoft tenants like your work tenant or whatever the case may be. So the first thing to do is to go to Google and you want to search for Microsoft 365 Business Standard Trial. Now, we're not actually going to set up Microsoft 365 Business Standard. We're just using this as a way to shortcut the tenant creation process. So there should be a try button somewhere
Yeah,
here. So there
sorry.
you go.
Yeah, let me just search trial.
Yeah.
There you go.
There you
So
go.
this is the page that you really want to land on, right? Cool.
So then do try 113. There you go. So this email can be whatever you want it to be. It doesn't really matter.
Just do that. Click on setup
Yep.
account. Then we will do this. We'll do this. Company name. I'll call it what the company of my
Yep.
community. So that's what I will do. I'll do choose 2 to 4 people. I'll choose United Kingdom. And
Yep.
you have to enter a phone number. Now, if you have trouble entering your phone number, if you're from a different country, make sure you just select your country or region
Yep.
first, and then it'll allow you to enter your phone number. So I'm just going to enter my phone number and I'm going to blur this out. And now we'll click next. And then we'll send a verification code. That's why you
So
have to use an actual number, right?
this so the phone number that you provide and the information can be whatever. The verification number has to be a real cell phone number that and it can't be a VoIP number. Ask me how I know.
Right, so we will verify that.
So now we've verified that we are not machines.
And
Now,
then
this is the part where you're going through the creation of the tenant. So you'll see under that domain name, that on Microsoft.com domain, that's what the name of your tenant is going to be. And after you've created that name, you can't change that name. And that name has to be globally unique. So if you're doing this for a real organization, be careful. You're making a choice that you can't change.
great, thank you for that. So I've changed it to Cav Terraform 5 in this case. I'll click on save, so that'll save it in. I'll
Yep.
have Andre, and I've inputted my password here, and I'll click next.
Now this is the part where we wait just a little bit. This does the tenant creation.
Okay.
Now you see, this expects you to pay, but the trick is that you don't have to pay. So if you just go from here directly to portal.azure.com.
Okay, so what I'm going to do then is I'm going to open
Yeah,
up a new
I know.
tab. I'm
Yeah.
going to put portal.azure.com. And
Do it in that same tab.
okay, yeah. I think it's because I'm incognito, right? If I was doing it from the, if I was not in an incognito, then.
No, I think it's probably incognito.
Yeah.
Yeah. So just sign in. It'll be fine. No, sign in with the new account that you just created.
So that would be Andre at Caf Terraform 5. Dot on Microsoft com.
Yeah.
Yeah. There we are. I'm glad we got that actually, because some people may not, and if they get that as well, how to actually sign in. So remember,
Yeah.
the email that you put in actually helps you with that. So, just remember what you've actually put. So I
Yeah.
put Andre as my username and at CafTerraform5.
Okay. And then here, just to validate, you can search for Azure Active Directory. You could click on Azure Active Directory right there in the middle of the page.
Okay, so I am here and I've got CafTerraform 5. So this
And there
is
you go.
our tenant, and now we will work on the subscriptions. Right, for this section, we are now gonna create a subscription. So we've created a tenant before, and as you can see, I'm Andre at CafTerraform 5. So first of all, I will click on subscriptions. I will add a new subscription. And Which one should w is it best for people to go to? Is it usually the free trial one or?
So you should use the free trial one unless you've abused the free trial so much that you've been banned, like I have been.
Yeah, or
So.
the Azure for students. So if you have like some sort of idea like attendance of college, maybe that's what you might go for. But in this case, we're
Yeah.
just gonna select free trial. So it's
If you
gonna.
have an EDU account, the student one will probably work for you.
And it's going to put in all this information. So of course you have to verify twice, right? So you have to verify using your phone number, and you also have to verify using the card as well. So first of all, we're gonna go in for all this information. We're going to, I believe, we need to verify again, right? So I'm just gonna write text me to get the my code. Cool. So that has been verified. Going to agree to the stuff, so press next. I
Yeah,
have
it's
to
gonna
write
want
an
to know any info.
address. So again, I will blur this all out while. And yeah, I'm not like this is the one thing which I've always tried to find in terms of videos. I for some reason I couldn't find this one going through, but yeah. So I filled in all my address details. I've clicked next. And now it's gonna ask me to verify by card. So like I mentioned before, you need a credit card for this. So yeah, or debit. Basically Visa, American Express, or Mastercard. Right, now that I've filled in all my credit card details, including the address, I'm going to click on sign up.
Let's see if you've made too many trials.
Yeah, because basically, you won't accept the credit card. And like, if you've used the credit card before, it won't let you. Oh.
Ah, yep.
Yeah, I think I've used it before. I think I've used it before, this credit card. But, okay, I'll just sign up for Azure for the normal account for now, for this one. But if you haven't actually.
Yeah, I think I've gotten two or three trials out of my combination of various credit cards and name. So yeah, you don't want
Yeah,
any,
you don't want
we
any
don't, you don't
technical
need any
support.
support.
Exactly. So
Unnecessary.
that's what you kind of just sign up for. I'm just showing you guys how you sign up to it, but essentially, if you were just starting off brand new, you wouldn't have had the problems I just had. But it would have just said, yeah, that's fine. But in this case, it should actually just allow me to and set up my subscription and. In that way, I will now have an actual subscription, and we will check out the subscription, and we will also check out the customer and billing. So let's just click. It's gonna take us to the subscription area now. So if I check subscriptions, you can see I have an Azure subscription one. If you want
Yep.
to, you can go into the Azure subscription. You can rename it if you would like. So for example, I could call it. Terraform. It takes us around 15 minutes to, well, 10 to 15 minutes to properly show up everywhere. So I'm just gonna rename it quickly. And in this way, now we have a subscription to work with for our tenant for the next future videos, I'll probably be using a different subscription, but this is how basically you would create one. Is there anything else you want to add to this?
No, I think this is everything that we wanted to cover. Oh. We made an Azure AD tenant, and we made a subscription under that tenant. So
one of the other things I want to quickly chat on about is billing scope. So essentially what happens is when you create a subscription, you basically go under a certain billing scope. And that is why, this is basically what happens when you create a subscription. In the background, it creates you a billing scope as well. So what you can do actually is when you actually go on a subscription now, you can create new subscriptions without any problems, because essentially your billing profile on a tenant has actually already been set up. So that whole introductory area, that's what we're talking about. It's basically creating you a billing account. And in this way, now you can use a billing profile, and I can create a CAF Terraform 2 subscription, and I can just review and create this. And now it's going to create me a secondary subscription. And that's one of the ways you could have multiple subscriptions under one billing profile.
Yep, they've really improved the experience for making additional subscriptions. I remember when you had to go through that same billing setup every time.
Yeah, so I'm so grateful for Microsoft too. Okay, now that the subscription actually has been created, you may go into home and you may go into subscriptions. But one of the things that you might not be able to see is you might not be able to see your new subscription being created. So one of the reasons for that is that it usually has a global filter. So you can actually, first of all, either click here, and this is going to show you all the subscriptions from the global filter, but it's actually going to do subscriptions all. So if you can't see your subscription, you can do it that way. The other way you can do it is if you actually go into a switch directory, and over here you can select, you have your default subscription filter, so you can actually select your subscriptions to be, for example, all subscriptions. So now when you actually go into your subscriptions, you will see that as part of the global filter, you will have both of the subscriptions. So that is how you can actually work and view with your selected subscriptions that you want to work with.
Yeah, that's a very important trick that trips people up who do this professionally. So
yeah,
it's good to understand this.
Yeah. And I believe that's it for this video.
This was cool. Thank you for having me.
Well, I hope you enjoyed this one, and thank you for making it to the end of the video. If you like this content, please give it a like, hit that bell, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And then follow me on LinkedIn. Feel free to connect with me. Feel free to message me. Join my community as well. And I will see you on the next video, which will be about repos, DevOps, working with Git, and working with Visual Studio Code. You don't want to miss that one. I'll see you there.